Right, so it's going real well, right up to the point where it suddenly wasn't. What other options do we have? We could throw exercise balls. Right, there's still a bunch of people around. Is that someone, or is that just... Oh yeah, there is someone down there. I thought that was just like a mannequin or something for a moment, but I guess not. So, how
kitchen, gym are clear.
Would one sneak through here quietly? I mean, there's over there.
The public has found us guilty. We have no chance.
Never been
but we get spiked the minute we stand up here. Is there a bit there we can walk across? Kinda.
Get him!
Get who? Oh, me! Okay. Did we get away with that? Maybe. Maybe we got away with that. Right, so there's a camera there. Don't think it can quite see the body that we've just left on the floor, so that's good.
We will have a lot to do once the police leave.
Are you going to come over here, or are you going to stay there? You're going to stay there. Very well. What if we jump up here? Is this a sneaky bit where we can sidle about without getting into any trouble? Right, looks like we're not in any trouble in here, but also that it doesn't lead anywhere useful. Right, camera kind of spotted us. Okay, very well. Let's go with revolver. Oh, who are you? Where'd you come from? Oh shit, there's more of them. So they all came pouring through that window, I think. Ah well. Right, is there some sort of control room around here? Doesn't seem to be much on the first floor. Second floor, nothing labelled control room. Because if we could find a control room, which we picked up a pocket secretary for, maybe we could turn off cameras and whatnot. But there doesn't seem to be anything labelled control room. So, I mean, we could turn off the cameras by hacking, or using a multi-tool in that case. But there's got to be more ways through than just... than just one path that's heavily guarded. Like maybe this window. Where is this taking us to? It's giving us a machine pistol to dismantle. Good. Giving us lockers to look in. Right, so those two lads are the two that blindsided me. That's fine. Nothing around there, really. So let's make those guys sus. Maybe we can get one of them to sneak around the corner. Yeah, you just stand with your face right in the wall, my friend. Things aren't going to be terribly easy for you one way or the other, so... that's fine. Now, I assume that other guy is going to come back to this room at some point soon. Let's see. Yeah, here he comes. Yeah, you, my friend, should go over there, please. Bam. And still none of them have tried to shoot us in this particular timeline. The only times they've tried to shoot is we've then just died, so the non-killing will continue until violence actually happens. Aha! Cameras off, laser grids off. Very nice. And this is the control room, it seems. And yet, we still haven't got a password for the control room computer. I'm sure we picked one up, but it's not important. The main thing is we've turned off the cameras and whatnot. And we've got a buy and sell. Lovely. Oh, we haven't turned off all the laser grids. We've just turned off the first one. How does that help us then? So remote hacking could take care of that, I guess, but that's not our style. We haven't got any spare praxis, have we? So we can't buy like Icarus Dash or anything like that. So why would you have two separate laser grids and only have the first one switched off by the old security camera thing? Camera one, laser grid off. So this hasn't actually helped me in the slightest. Unless there's a vent. That's how we get past laser grid number two. Deeper into Ark territory. Lovely. Now what, we've got a window. This is where we died. We're still technically not deeper into our territory. There we go.
Thankfully, no. What's your progress?
I'm through the living quarters. Looks like I'm into some kind of operations area now. My gut tells me Rucker's gonna be above all this, someplace high and defensible.
Better find an elevator then. I'll update you with extraction coordinates when I have
Bonk.
Them. Chicane out.
And we have got a new praxis now. Do we spend it straight away? We got rebreathers. We got Typhoon. We got the armor we wanted. We got the legs we wanted. We got most of the battery we wanted. That's health, which is fine, I guess. That extends the radar detection radius. Let's get it. Seems pretty useful, all told. And now we can suddenly see that there's people all over the place. But none of them are in here, and that's the main thing. Oh, those two just stood right there. I suspect we can't just waltz up and double take them without them seeing us approaching.
Walk around their marketplace.
They're busy.
And handle Posse at the clinics.
So yeah, we got away with that. That earns you a good chunk of XP for taking out two dudes at once. Inventory's full at this point, so we're not getting any more weapon parts. Yeah, we can barely carry any extra stuff right now. Do we want to make some mines? Are we ever going to use mines? We've got like 5 mine templates. We're picking up loads of ammo that we're not using. Be nice if it's stacked a bit higher, but hey-ho. So, pressing on, we find another couple of people having a convo that we might be able to take out in the same fashion as we just took them out. They are behind a door, but maybe that's fine. No one else further in appears to be looking at them.
What if we did blow up Ruzik?
You think Talos would allow that?
So, down they go. Oh no, shit, that was just one of them.
Oh, sacra!
Not enough energy. Dagnam it. Jeez!
Look at that traitor's face!
Did we, like, have no health or something? I mean, maybe we do want to upgrade our health a little bit. But that should have been a double takedown. I'm not impressed with that not being a double takedown, because they were clearly both just there. Practically in each other's faces.
You think?
Look! We got...
There we go. That was double. Although, they might have... Yep. People are suspicious. Are you going to come down and look at this body?
I think we have nothing here.
Really? Two of your mates are on the floor. Are you not going to...
Come on.
Do anything about
nothing
that?
Here either.
Honestly.
There, there.
We need to keep looking. Do we deal with the body?
Okay, now it's kicked off. And we've got low health. Where is she? There she goes. Well, oh, fuck off.
Yes, yes. I have to call my mother. Excuse me.
What? I mean, we could do this the more straightforward way, I suppose. I mean, I bought double takedown because I thought I was going to be able to take down two dudes at once, but if they're not going to allow that, then we'll just do this instead, I guess. Alright, is that door going to stay open?
Probably just that air.
Right, we've lured over a dude. Although, he doesn't seem to want to come through the door. That's fine, we'll bring him through the door. His mate hopefully won't be too concerned about that. Oh, what we got here? Not a lot. Victor Marchenko has sent someone an email. Now, yeah, this guy is entirely unconcerned about the fact that his mate's fallen down. Those are the ones up there, though. Might be in a position to prevent me from knocking this lad out. Let's see. No, I don't think they saw that. Good. Alright, so you come in here and sit tight. I mean, either way, we're going through here, so we didn't really need to knock that guy out. You can have a bit of that. Now, we probably want to tuck her back over here, though. She also had a compute. Yeah. Pocket secretary. Come see me. From Max to Oleg. This side route seems to be working out well. A couple of dudes over there, though. So let's just keep sneaking around, shall we? A bit sneaky stealthy. This is, after all, why we play Deus Ex games, for a bit the old sneaky stealthy. Maybe a bit of the gunny upgradey. Did we... yeah, we fully did the revolver, so it's combat rifle and sniper rifle now, isn't it? Oh, is this where I'm thinking of? Is this, like, where I thought the elevator should be that allows us to get higher up? Or am I just talking nonsense? Because we seem to be able to just climb all the way up here. So maybe this isn't the spot where I got stuck last time I played. Grant, we're up the top. Now what's that going to do for us? I mean, it's going to allow us to take out this person.
Last batch of posters came up this color.
Another one down there. How far around are you coming, friend?
We need new cameras.
You're gonna park yourself there. You're then gonna come back this way. And just do a little circle.
Been a long week.
Yep, you're just a circler. Now, there's only one other lad in the vicinity, so we probably don't even need to move this guy, but better safe than sorry. Mission marker saying we should be on a lower floor, but Jensen said himself that Talos is probably on an upper floor. That guy going to be concerned about me scuttling? Not really. He's just pretty chill about everything. He'll be even more chill in a second. Now, those two down there are just having a convo, I guess.
Is that some kind of crime?
Hello. Right, that might be this top floor cleared out of goons. Access the elevator, says the mission marker. Does being on this top floor actually help us access the elevator at all? It gives us more loot. Maybe that elevator that we're due to access is the one that just wasn't working out for me when I played previous. So we've got an elevator over here. Are you the elevator? Or are you a different one? Or do we have to switch you on from somewhere else? Because you're definitely an elevator. So it's saying go over there. And then it was saying go to floor 2, wasn't it? What if I just drop down this elevator shaft? Can I not just gain access to the elevator that way? Because I feel like this might go even higher up. And this might be an elevator that we need. Someone's slightly sus about the fact that someone just appeared to fall out of the sky. That's fine. What floor are we on now? We're on level 2 now. We are on top of the elevator. Definitely a sus boy out there. Be nice if we could just drop into it.
Clear. There's nothing.
But alas, that seems to not be the case. So maybe we should have been on the first floor all the time.
Later.
Right, let's craft a multi-tool, because I seem to recall that there might have been a praxis in one of these security rooms. But I could be wrong. Let's see, neither of them had a way in through the roof, did they? No. Is that a, that's a level 3. Is one of them a level 5? No, they're both level 3. Okay. We'll just hack this one, see what's what. Although it looks like the middle one might have a camera in it as well. But yeah, this one's got a biocell, more crafting parts. Mine templates again. And a combat rifle. So nothing amazing, really.
I doubt the police will follow the law in this case.
No. What if we dismantle some shotgun ammo? Does that give us the space we need to pick up weapons again? It does. So we could dismantle this combat rifle as well. And we might have enough for another multi-tool. Good. Let's see what we had in door number 2. A trank rifle. And a weapons briefcase with some grenades and whatnot. So yeah, nothing terribly exciting. So now where should we go? I feel like dropping down and taking people down from the top down might be a good solution. Although there's an elevator door. Have we seen that before? I don't know. Maybe this isn't the elevator we're after. 7th floor, 2nd floor, down floor. Ground floor. So maybe we need a different elevator to get to where we're going.
Much later.
Right, what does the map tell us? Now it's telling us to go back up to the top floor. Now that we've jumped all the way down, it's saying go back up. What is going on? So yeah, this might have been the issue I was having previously. Now that we're going up, it's saying go back down again. So if we drop back down to this level, now it's saying we're 3.2 meters away from where we need to be. But it's also still saying level 5. So maybe we ignore the map marker for now and we just try and work our way up, because Jensen himself said that Talos Rucker would probably be up top. So maybe we take that as a sign that we should in fact be as high up as we can possibly get. And then we got this room, which features a whole lot of nothing. Really? Yep, not a lot going on here. Some guy having a nap. Can't imagine why. I didn't mean to pick up the gun. I wanted to dismantle the gun. Thank you. Have we got enough crafting parts now to max out like all of our guns? It'd be nice if you could just see from this screen what can be customised and what can't, rather than having to try and remember it. Everything now, I think, is maxed out with the exception of the sniper rifle. Let's see if I can remember that the next time I come back to play some more. There's a window there. But that led us into this room, which we'd been in before, maybe? There's another window. Need a rebreather to get through there. So these all just seem to be different ways to get to the top floor. But then what? What does happen if we go out this gas route? Is there anything going on down there that we can worry about? I mean, there's a valve. So we've killed the gas. We can go along here. Is this new? This does look new, actually. But then there's a little hole. Where's that going to take? Because that just drops us back down onto a lower level. Does that help us, though? Or is this us going backwards again? I feel like this is us going backwards again. And that's just yet another way to sneak up to the top floor.
Much, much later.
All right, who was down below us? If we drop down here, there's a lad. Are you the only one? Maybe. Looks like it. Someone heard that, though.
I'm moving in.
Where are they moving in? Where did that guy go that I just knocked out? Ah, down there. Right, so that's him out as well. I feel like that guy wasn't supposed to fall down there. Is there anything worthwhile doing down here, or have we just dropped in here for no good reason? Oh, there's a little zappy room. We like zappy room. Because we can deal with them. La la la. What does that do for us? Gives us access to another ladder. Are we in a new part that we couldn't get to except from down here? That's the question. Are you going to do much, or are you just going to chill? Well, kind of irrelevant now.
Anyone got something?
We'll bring you with us, just because. Yeah. Can't hurt to do so. Now it's telling us we need to be higher up. Is that a new laser grid, or is that one that we bypassed before? There's a turret over there as well.
Anyone got something? Over.
Awful lot of people around here. Which would suggest it's a fresh area.
Some guy killed his wife, their three kids, and then himself.
Yes, I heard.
Why can't we get in there?
And he thought he was doing what was best for his family.
Killing them was the best thing? Because they had no credits?
Despair makes some.
So yeah, they were chatting about some guy killing himself and all his family and stuff. That could be the room that we stumbled across earlier, where there was a bit of a murder mystery happening. But yeah, shockingly, it wasn't the best thing for his family after all. Who'd have thought it? Now, what's your computer got to say for itself? Anything tasty? It's another Arc Security computer. Mini storage code. Cool. We will take a code all day long. It's definitely a turret in the vicinity. We don't like those. It's going back and forth around here somewhere. There it is. But it didn't see us. But we are too clever for a turret. We're too clever for this man. Get bopped. We're not clever enough to know where we're going still, but such is life. Now, let's upgrade the damage on the sniper rifle and the ammo capacity. Rate of fire on a sniper rifle. It's like, come now. Yeah, it's a pricey one to upgrade, but we'll do it nonetheless. Locked computer. Marek Artem. He's got a picture and everything, so he's like a special dude, perhaps. So, Viktor Marchenko has sent Marek an email about a special task. So, they both love Talos, of course. Right, so Talos does seem to be a pacifist then, because Viktor and possibly Marek are willing to be a bit more martial. An initiative called Storm Surge. And Max saying that Victor was having trouble with his OS. And there's a password, which is Storm Surge, I guess. And then a letter from Dr. Rucker. Ah, here's Victor's own computer. Enter password. Storm Surge. Sticky door. Nice, it's another code. Red King. To old Blue Eye. So old Blue Eye, I guess, is Victor. Right. Red King might be selling something. Weapons, maybe? An email from Encrypted. Might have to lean on BH for reserves. Orlov is asking you bring some of your friends along. And that's from Roland Galler. Wasn't Orlov the Russian guy who Sarif interviewed? Let's see. Okay. It's just a whole bunch of names, basically, being bandied about. And yeah, that leaves me not sure where we stand on everything. That appears to be a picture of our man. Back before he was augmented, with his wife and his daughter, I presume. Kind of weird looking at them down the scope of a gun like that, but hey-ho. Now we're past the turret. But there is a man somewhere, I feel. He is stuck in a wall.
Probably nothing, right?
Probably nothing. Now, this is the elevator we need. Good.
Moving in on Rucker's position. You got those coordinates yet?
I'll transmit them as soon as I've finished my coffee.
Don't leave me hanging, Chicane.
You just worry about getting our man. And be careful. He's dangerous.
We'll see.
Right, so the elevator we were right next to wasn't the one we needed. It was another elevator miles away. And the map marker was useless. But here we are. We're about as far as I've ever got in the game. I don't remember if I spoke to Rucker last time or if I just couldn't get this far. I'm pretty sure I didn't speak to him. I either didn't speak to him or I got here after hours of frustration. And so I was just like, you know what? Sod it, I'm not playing anymore. But this time we're going all the way. So let's go see Dr. Rucker.
I'm Anam.
I'm sure you'll understand if I don't take your word for it.
You're clearly very skilled. I want to thank you for holding yourself in check on the way in. My friends only want to protect me, but there's been too much bloodshed already.
You don't seem surprised to see me.
I'm not. After the train station attacks, I knew it was only a matter of time before they sent someone. Please, sit.
This isn't a social call, Rucker. I'm here to take you in.
Our mandate is to fight for the rights of the augmented. Communicate our message, offer assistance. The Ark is a non-violent organization.
Well,
all right, then this should be easy. Come with me, answer our questions, and we'll have you back here in plenty of time to film your next sermon.
What are you doing,
I'm
Chase?
Not a fool. If I surrender now, I'm never coming back. Once you have me, you intend to make me disappear. But I will not make Solzhenitsyn's mistake.
Who?
My people and I will resist you.
I thought you were a pacifist.
I am. But I'm more than a leader. I'm a symbol. That is why you wish to erase me.
Who said anything about erasing
it? If martyrdom is the only way to remain a symbol, then even my death is preferable to my evaporation.
If I have to bring you in by force, I will. And your people will try to stop me.
Heavily augmented.
And neither of us wants anyone to get hurt, so come along peacefully.
I don't know what's gone on with his chest.
I will do everything I can to see that you are treated fairly.
Slightly distracted by Trace just leaping out of a hammock.
You cannot speak to me of peace or fairness. Not when your masters hide in the shadows, manipulating, controlling, murdering without the courage to proclaim their convictions in front of the rest of the world.
What about you, Chummer? Hiding up here in your ivory tower. Let's see. There we go. It's got ivory tower in it.
Come off it, Rucker. You've been preaching pacifism for years from your ivory tower. Now all of a sudden your convictions are really being tested and you're tossing them away.
No, that's... Let me explain. The augmented peoples of the world have been stripped of their power. There are so few advocates remaining. The cause needs people like me to stem the tide of hatred before all humanity drowns in it.
Does it need you, does it? Now, what do we go with here? Humanity is sick, Rucker. I don't know. That doesn't feel like a good one. Feels like a better bet might be having a chat with him about org rights and whatnot, because we suffer the same. So his plan just isn't working right now, which is for sure.
Lecturing me about the state of org rights? I get the same looks, I go through the same checkpoints. And things are getting worse, so your plan obviously isn't working.
I know, and it tears at me. I have been trying desperately to think of a better way, but so far nothing. This is a very precarious time for the movement. These attacks are making everything worse for us. My leadership position within ARC is being threatened, and I suspect the two might even be connected. Please go back to your people. Tell them to give me 48 hours so I can attempt to resolve the
I don't know if that's gonna work. We can't really give you that sort of sign, can we? I mean, that's true. They are going to keep pointing to him as the face of the enemy. But, I mean, that's definitely true. We are normally a vicious killing machine. We've managed to keep it in check today because nobody has really tried to shoot at us that much. But they might send an even more vicious person next time.
I'm sorry. If I go back empty-handed, I'll just be replaced. Probably by someone more eager and less sympathetic. Coming in now is honestly the best thing you can do for everyone.
Yes. I suspect you are right. But can you understand this? If you were to take me from here, you would be responsible for more than my death. You would be responsible for my effacement, the ruination of the Augmented Rights Coalition, and the perversion of everything it stands for.
Would we, though? I mean, it's being perverted anyway by everything else that's happening, I think. Yeah, they're going to have to go through me. Yeah, we're just going to kill off dozens of them. Yeah, choose the non-violent path, Rucker, if you're so non-violent.
The bottom line hasn't changed. If you come with me willingly, there won't be any violence. You now have the choice. Choose the non-violent path, or you are the one betraying the cause.
I...
Do it, lad.
Cannot watch any more of my people die. Not on my account.
Good.
You've asked me to trust you, and so... I will.
Yeah.
Before we leave together, there's something I must show you.
Ooh.
I suspect there's a power struggle brewing within our organization.
Yep.
Some people inside
Smachenko
committed to our ideals.
Are you trying to tell me you know who's responsible for the bombings?
I have only suspicions.
Oh, yeah.
And until recently, not even that.
And considered that it was actually an ARC bombing.
The evidence I have begun collecting is meager.
But a rogue cell of ARC.
This is the key card for the security door. The evidence is inside.
Why don't we just go in there now?
Why not keep it? Present it at your interrogation.
Because if my suspicions are correct, and I am seen leaving here with you willingly, I may not survive to present my evidence.
Well, let's just go in then and have a look at the evidence together. That seems like a good
somewhere
idea.
Down there, hiding in plain sight, is your real terrorist. I was trying secretly to find out who is responsible.
Rucker.
This doesn't look good. You're right, mate. We're gonna get the blame for this, aren't we?
Chicane, Rucker is dead.
Come again.
I'll fill you in when I see you. Which is where exactly?
There's some greenhouses near your position. Below them is a clearing. That's where I'll be. Chicane out.
Well, that's gone to tits, hasn't it? He just sort of fell over and died. I don't think anyone is going to believe me when I just say that he just fell over and died. But having caught a sneak peek at Rubina's architectural designs, I can honestly tell you this. Maybe the boss will. Maybe Miller will believe me. One can only hope. Because it doesn't look good, really, all told. Let's use his keycard reader. Rucker's evidence. Spoke to HK, Hong Kong, maybe? Phase 1 is go. Deliver Orchid ASAP, then maintain cover. Rest of cell on standby. Additional orders to follow. Jim Miller? Nah. There's a trank rifle in here. It's pretty non-violent of him. There's also a weapons briefcase. And yeah, non-violent ammo. Lovely. Now, that safe is bound to have something good in it. Do we have enough? We don't have enough for another multi-tool. But we can. Let's see, what's the cheapest things to dismantle? We can't dismantle. Oh, we can! We can dismantle this software stuff. Well, there you go, you learn something new every day. It's beginning to look like Miller's a dodgy bugger, you know. Praxis! Nice. Triangle code, neuropazine. Still not sure about the triangle codes. Don't really care. Talos, what's your computer got to say for itself? Someone thanking Mr. Rucker for being a top bloke. Right, non-violence has not worked for us. Listen to Marchenko. So yeah, maybe Marchenko was behind the bombing. And yep, Lily thinks that he's pretty cool. And something regarding the Safe Harbor Initiative. Okay. Doesn't want to see his people end up in ghettos. Which is fair.
What are you talking about?
Couple of lads. Hi, friends. Yeah, you're kind of in the way. Now, are you going to come strolling over? Oh shit, there's a drone. This ain't good. Where is our extraction point anyway? And we're dead.